Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's Tanner here, and welcome to a new Ninjago video here on the channel. In today's video, we are going to be talking about one of Ninjago's biggest failures, at least in terms of a Ninjago set that I've seen in recent years. And to me, the first thing that comes to mind whenever I think of a Ninjago set that failed is the Fire Fang. And I'm not talking about the actual design for the Fire Fang itself. I do feel like the actual snake itself is a very solid build. To me, it looks really cool. I love the Cobra aesthetic to it, but it was never a set that I was, I guess, hyped up for. It was never something that I was planning on getting, and this is probably something that I never will get if I ever go back and try to, I guess, acquire some of the older Ninjago sets that I might have missed out on. So what am I talking about? What makes this thing a failure? Well, pretty much like I said, even though this is something that I think is really cool, this would not be something that I would buy. And I feel like a lot of people hold that same opinion. The piece of evidence that I have to prove that is because I see this thing everywhere still. Walmart, Target, no matter what, the Fire Fang is always there. It's the only Season 11 set that I even see in stores nowadays, meaning that a lot of these guys were either, I guess, overly stocked, or they didn't sell very well. I'm opting to go with the second option there. I'm for sure thinking that these guys didn't sell very well, and that's why I keep on seeing so many of them. They're still available on LEGO.com, and to my knowledge, they're one of the oldest sets still available and still in stock. A lot of the Ninjago Legacy stuff from this time is out of stock because people actually bought that. The Fire Fang, not a lot of people buy. I mean, this is a good thing for people that really want Fire Fangs and want a lot of them. If for some reason you're a really big fan of Asphira's army from Season 11, obviously there were a bunch of Fire Fangs just kind of running around in her army, so army building here is definitely not going to be an issue for people that want that, especially considering how there are a lot of these things still left on store shelves. These things are probably going to go on clearance very soon. I've kind of been holding out hope as well that these things will go on clearance, because obviously I do want the Asphira minifigure. That's a figure that I still don't have just yet, so if there's ever a reason for me to get the Fire Fang, it would be to get that Asphira figure, but I wouldn't pay more than maybe $8 for that, and I doubt that the Fire Fang is going to be going down to that level anytime soon. So no, I feel like the Fire Fang overall isn't a bad set. There's some stuff in there that I really enjoy. It's just overall, I see this thing everywhere. It makes me feel like this thing hasn't really sold very well. Still available at my local Walmart, Target, you name it. Barnes & Noble, they have it there. Barnes & Noble, side note, has a lot of really cool Ninjago stuff. If you're ever looking for Ninjago stuff that's kind of old, go to Barnes & Noble. They got a lot there. But back to my main point, did the Fire Fang fail as a set? In my opinion, yes and no. It didn't really fail in terms of design. The actual design itself is gorgeous, and I love the overall, like, a shape of the serpent itself, the Cobra, if you will. But in terms of selling, yeah, I feel like it did fail. Let me know down below in the comments if you guys are seeing any Fire Fang sets around your area. I know specifically around here they are very, very common, along with a couple of leftover Lloyd's Titan mechs from Season 11, which of course I'm still kind of debating as to whether or not I actually want to get it. Part of me wants it, part of me wants to wait until it goes on clearance. Let me know down below in the comments what your thoughts are. And I'm also curious to see if any other sets are following the same fate. So let me know down below in the comments as well if there are sets in your area that you've just seen over and over again, especially older sets like from Legacy, First Wave, Season 11 perhaps. Let me know down below in the comments. With all that being said, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you did, feel free to like, comment, and subscribe. Do all that fun stuff and check out the links down below in the description for my other forms of social media. As always, big shout out goes out to my Patreon supporters, including once again the Marvelous Jan. Thank you guys so much for watching this video once again. My name is Tanner Fishies, and with that, I bid you farewell.